Riparian habitats are found in association with water bodies. These habitats contain a diverse variety of plant species and provide important ecosystem functions. Trees in these areas increase floodwater retention and slow water velocity. Plants help to filter sediments and nutrients from water draining from upland sites. Roots protect stream banks from erosion. Riparian areas provide excellent habitat for wild pigs. These dense, low-lying areas allow wild pigs to move across the landscape unseen in the thick vegetative cover. While using these areas as travel corridors, wild pigs opportunistically feed on the roots and mass of the plants found nearby. Wild pigs also take advantage of the abundant water found within this habitat, especially during the hot summer months when they are commonly found wallowing along the water's edge. The combination of dense vegetation, low elevation, and abundant water makes riparian areas a prime location for wild pig activity.
Vegetation in riparian areas can be impacted by wild pigs through both destruction and consumption. Destruction commonly occurs by trampling and the pig's wallowing behaviors. Research suggests that vegetation is a primary diet item of wild pigs, and riparian areas host a diverse variety of plant species. The regrowth of mass-producing trees can be severely impacted through consumption of acorns and seeding roots. This disruption in the growth cycle can have long-lasting impacts on riparian areas. Rooting and wallowing are the primary forms of soil disturbance caused by wild pigs in riparian areas. These behaviors increase soil erosion and reduce the stability of stream banks while also introducing additional sediment into the water. Soil nutrient losses are another consequence of destructive behaviors. Throughout most of the year, wild pigs are found in close association with water for biological reasons. These associations lead to the deposition of fecal matter in or adjacent to the water, resulting in increased bacteria and nutrient levels. Elevated bacteria levels in water bodies can contribute to cloudy water and increased oxygen demand, as well as a variety of other water impairments.
Several options exist for abating wild pig damage. These options can be lethal or non-lethal. Non-lethal methods attempt to deter wild pigs from utilizing an area. One of these is exclusion fencing, which can be an effective technique for land managers to deter wild pig damage. However, fencing is expensive and no fence design is 100% pig-proof. Lethal techniques vary by state, and it's important to understand local regulations prior to implementing lethal control. In Texas, land managers have 4 legal methods to abate wild pig damage. These include trapping, shooting, snaring, and the use of trained dogs. A wild pig management program should incorporate each one of these techniques to effectively abate wild pig damage. Reducing wild pig populations in and around riparian areas can allow these areas to function properly. You can find an abundance of information on wild pig management on our website, feralhogs.tamu.edu.